हेलो रीडर्स, वेलकम टू हैरी पॉटर्स वीक डे 5 बुक 5। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस हैरी पॉटर एंड द ऑर्डर ऑफ द फिनिक्स द मोस्ट बिगेस्ट पार्ट सी द थिकनेस एंड इट हैज 38 चैप्टर्स एंड 800 पेजेस। Harry, along with his cousin Dudley, gets attacked by Dementors in the street, Little Whinging. Harry uses Patronus Charm, hence gets expelled from school. Due to Dumbledore, he is given some compensation and he gets a hearing on 12th of August, which will decide expulsion or innocence. The Dursleys were very angry with Harry. While Harry was struggling to get Dudley to home after the attack, he found that Mrs. Fig, his neighbor, was a squib. A squib is someone whose parents were wizards and witches, but the child is a muggle. One day, while the Dursleys had gone to a competition, a group of wizards and witches, along with Lupin and Moody, come to rescue Harry. They do not go to Weasley's house, the burrow, but to number 12 Grimmauld Place, Sirius's ancestral house. This place was used as headquarters for the Order of the Phoenix, an organization created by Dumbledore to fight against Voldemort. Harry meets Ron and Hermione, while others were at the Order's meeting. Harry was so angry at them as they did not tell him anything about the Wizarding World. But Dumbledore had made them swear not to tell anything. He also meets Ginny, Fred and George, who express their grudges for not being allowed on the meeting. They also reveal that Percy was promoted as the personal assistant to Minister, hence has a row with Mr. Weasley about supporting Dumbledore and believing Harry. Percy leaves the house. At dinner, Harry asks about Voldemort. Where is he? What is he doing? What are his plans? And he gets to know just that there is something, weapon, which Voldemort desires. They start cleaning the house from the next day. At 12th of August, Harry wins the hearing due to witness Mrs. Digg and the witness for defense, Dumbledore. However, Dumbledore does not talk to or see to Harry even once. The day before Hogwarts reopens, Ron and Hermione get the news that they are prefects. The next day, at Trent, they get to know that even Malfoy is a prefect. They meet Luna Lovegood while going to Hogwarts. Harry notices for the first time that carriages were led by some creatures. He gets to know later that they are Thestrals and those who have seen death of someone can see it. The animal shown in the cover page is actually a Thestral. Harry gets to know that Angelina Johnson is the Gryffindor Quidditch team captain. They get their new Defense Against the Dark Arts teacher, Dolores Jane Umbridge, Under Secretary to Minister. Hermione makes a statement that Ministry is now interfering at Hogwarts. At the dormitory, Harry and Seamus have a row because Seamus believes in Ministry. On their Defense Against the Dark Arts classes, they are told to study only theory. No wands. This was not told in any of their previous classes before. Harry mentions Voldemort thrice, resulting in his detention. In detention, he had to write, "I must not tell lies." However, the punishment was that the ink Umbridge's pen used was the writer's blood. After this, Sirius visited Harry just like the previous year. From the Gryffindor common room fire, Percy wrote a letter to Ron, congratulating him to be a prefect and warning him to stay away from Harry, which Ron tore. Soon, Umbridge was appointed the High Inquisitor of Hogwarts. She investigates every teacher's way of teaching and gives a report on whether they have passed the test or they are put in probation. The trip is also depressed due to absence of Hagrid. Hermione gets the idea of starting their own classes. They collect as many people as possible and meet in Hogsmeade at Hogshead, a bar. Next day, they get new rule that all meetings are not allowed unless due to the permission of High Inquisitor. This also means Quidditch team. Hedwig gets injured when she is bringing Harry's letter from Sirius. That night, when Sirius is talking to Harry, a hand comes to catch him. Umbridge knew somehow Sirius was coming here. She had read Harry's letter. Now the trio starts with Dumbledore's army. Dobby tells Harry about the Room of Requirement, which is visible only to those who need it. Whatever you need inside, you get. That is what the Room of Requirement does. Hermione invented galleon coins which will display dates and time of the next meeting. In the Quidditch match, Ron played keeper. After Gryffindor wins, Harry and George fight with Malfoy due to his insulting their parents. They are banned to play Quidditch by Umbridge. Hagrid returns. He had gone to find giants along with Madame Maxime, a professor of Beauxbatons Academy of Magic. Both were half giants, hence given this task. Before Christmas, Harry sees a vision that Mr. Weasley was attacked by a snake and Harry himself was seen from snake's perspective. He informs McGonagall, who takes him to Dumbledore. He confirms and support key sends Weasley children Harry to Sirius's house. They visit Mr. Weasley on Christmas. There, they meet ex-professor Lockhart and Neville's parents. Harry knew their condition due to seeing in pensive last year, but others didn't. Actually, some Death Eaters had tortured Neville's parents, Frank and Alice Longbottom, to madness. Hence, they still not recover well till today. Harry was recommended to start an occlumency session. Occlumency means to control and stop the mind with Snape. In February's Hogsmeade trip, he meets Hermione and Luna at Three Broomsticks along with Rita Skeeter, the reporter. She writes an article about what Harry says, or as Hermione had threatened, a secret that she can turn into beetle as she is unregistered animagus will reveal. The Quibbler sells fast and Harry gains fame and support again. Soon, Trelawney, the divination teacher, is sacked. Dumbledore asks her to stay at Hogwarts and arranges a new divination teacher, Firenze, the centaur. In their next DA class, Dobby comes to warn Harry about Umbridge. They try to hide, but Harry is caught. Cho's friend, Marietta, gives the information about Dumbledore's army. But the info was jinxed, hence she gets warts on her face, which make up the word sneak. They get hold of the list of students. Dumbledore rescues them by saying that it was not Potter's army, but Dumbledore's army. Dumbledore was sacked and Umbridge became headmistress. She makes an organization called Inquisitorial Squad, which includes most of the Slytherins. Umbridge calls Harry to ask about Dumbledore and Sirius's whereabouts. Actually, she had added the truth potion Veritas Serum in Harry's teacup. But Harry does not say the truth. And this happens because Professor Snape had given to Umbridge the fake potion. At Occlumency, Snape tells Harry to continue to Muggle due to some problem arising. Harry finds in the pensive about Snape's memory. It showed how James was cruel to Snape and how he used to make fun of him due to no reason. Harry feels a tinge of hatred for Sirius and James. Snape tells him that he will never teach occlumency again to Harry. Harry then has his career guidance, after which he meets Sirius and Lupin from Umbridge's fire. He talks about what he saw in pensive. Then Fred and George fly away in their broomsticks. In the Quidditch match that followed, Harry and Hermione were led by Hagrid to see his stepbrother Grock, who was a giant and was kept in the Forbidden Forest. Hagrid had brought him from where giants lived. Harry and Hermione returned to find that Ron had made great saves and Gryffindor won. Soon, the OWLS, Ordinary Wizarding Levels exam, start. In astronomy practicals, Umbridge and the ministry officials come to arrest Hagrid. McGonagall comes in rescue and four stunning spells attack her. Hagrid runs to forest. At the last exam, Harry's car halts and he sees Sirius tortured by Voldemort in the Department of Mysteries, the room which he saw in his sleep. McGonagall is not found as she is taken to St. Mungo's Hospital due to four stunning spells shot at her. He creates distractions and tries to go in Umbridge's fire, but is cornered. The squad also gathers. Hermione makes up everything about the weapon made by Dumbledore hidden in the forest. They give Umbridge away to Sentius, but they are angry at Harry and Hermione too. Hence, Grop rescues them. Harry, Ron, Hermione, Neville, Ginny and Luna. The six of them go to Department of Mysteries, find the correct door, but don't find Sirius. Instead, when they take out from the shelf a crystal globe with Harry's name on it, that he tells turn up, led by Lucius Malfoy, father of Draco Malfoy, and Bellatrix Lestrange, cousin of Sirius, and the one who tortured Neville's parents to madness. This was the way. It was a prophecy. Only the one on whom the prophecy is made can take it out of the shelf. Voldemort wanted it to know how he can defeat Harry. He had been taking Harry here in his dreams so that he can do this task. Everyone fight against the Death Eaters and reach another room, where the Order members arrive. They fight a lot until Sirius is killed by Bellatrix. Harry tries to cause her in anger. He goes behind her to the atrium and encounters Voldemort there. Dumbledore comes in rescue. At the same time, Ministry arrives and they notice Voldemort. At Hogwarts, Harry destroys Dumbledore's possessions in anger. Dumbledore then explains to Harry about the prophecy. It said that the one who was born on 31st July, who will be born to those who tries to defy him, who will be marked as Voldemort's equal, and who possessed a weapon which Voldemort did not have, that was love, will be the slayer of Voldemort. This applied to Harry as well as Neville. Dumbledore also explains that Harry's mother died and protected Harry with a shield charm. By going every year to Dursley's, Harry's safety is maintained. Petunia had Lily's blood, so she shielded the charm placed upon Harry. Everyone gets well again. Umbridge is removed and our tragic story ends. Stay tuned for part 6. Thank you.